A Kentucky pastor has just died of a snake bite as he was handling snakes in a church service. A Kentucky pastor who starred in a reality show about snake handling in church has died of a snake bite. Jamie Coots died Saturday night, last night, after refusing to be treated, according to Middleboro, Kentucky police. On snake salvation, the Pentecostal believer said that he believed that a passage in the Bible suggests poisonous snake bites will not harm believers as long as they're anointed by God. The practice is illegal in most states, but still goes on primarily in rural southern states. Coots was a third generation serpent handler and inspired to one day pass the practice on in his church, which is a full gospel tabernacle in Jesus' name in Kentucky. Now, the National Geographic show featured Coots and cast the fact that he handled snakes. It was on a documentary. He handled very poisonous snakes, copperheads, rattlesnakes, cottonmouths. The National Geographic website shows a picture of Coots with his goatee wearing and also holding up a snake, even the fact that he even lost a finger from a snake bite, and other people have died during these snake handling services. Jamie Coots still believed he must take up serpents and follow the holiness faith. On Sunday, National Geographic Channel spokeswoman Stephanie Montgomery, this afternoon, not long ago, just told CNN, in following Pastor Coots for our series, Snake Salvation, we were constantly struck by his devout religious convictions, despite the health and legal peril he would often face. Quote, those risks were always worth it to him and to his congregation. Folks, first of all, very sad to hear this tragic news. Very sad to hear this, and we want you to pray for his family and his congregation of believers. This will definitely come a major shock to them, and they'll be very distraught by this. Now, let me read the scripture to you that Jamie Coots and many other snake handling believers, what are they basing this type of religious practice on? Well, the Bible says in Mark chapter 16, verse 15, it says, Jesus said these words, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Now, the problem with this passage of scripture is people's interpretation of it. Certainly, you could drink something accidentally that is poisonous, and if you have faith and you prayed and asked God to help you and heal you or protect you, certainly the Lord can and He will. But if you tempt the Lord thy God, there's no reason to go and get snakes, bring them into the church house, and start handling them as if this is some type of religious practice. This is not what Jesus Christ meant. He meant in the demonic world, when you're dealing with demonic spirits and devils, you will have power over them because of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. He did say, go into all the world and preach the gospel, baptizing them. He did tell us to cast out devils. He did tell us that people will speak with new tongues. He did say, you can lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. But the interpretation of the serpents and to actually literally think it means to go around picking up serpents and tempting God is not what Jesus meant. Now, you could get bit by a snake. I'm going to give you an example. In the Bible, Apostle Paul was bit by a deadly viper on the hand. He had been shipwrecked. The boat he was on had ran into a tremendous storm, and he was shipwrecked. And they were gathering wood to build a fire. And as they were building this fire and gathering wood, Paul had a bunch of wood, and he walked over to the blazing fire, and he threw the wood into the fire. Just as he threw the wood into the fire, a viper came out of the pile of wood, out of the fire, and bit Apostle Paul on the hand. The natives that were in the land that were watching immediately expected to see him fall dead. The type of viper he was bit with should have killed him in 10 seconds. Instead, the Bible says Paul shook the snake off back into the fire and went on praising the Lord and never died. Now, he had power over that's exactly the faith he had. But he wasn't looking for serpents. He wasn't looking for trouble. He ran into it. And he was protected by the power of God because of the anointing in his life.